The maximum lift to drag ratio of the World War I Camel was 7.7. If the aircraft is in flight at 7,500 feet, when the engine fails, how far can it glide in terms of distance measured along the ground? So let's go ahead and start by pulling out the knowns in the equation. We have a lift to drag ratio of 7.7. Let's see, we have an altitude, a height of 7,500 feet. Now we also have information here that the engine has failed. So we know we're going to be in a power off glide. So I'll just put glide. And what are our unknowns? Our unknown would be the distance measured along the ground that it can go. We call this range. What is the aircraft's range? Let's go ahead and take a look at what this airplane will look like and the forces it will see in flight. I got a very poor drawing right here. Let's say I have a local horizon. We'll go and mark that local horizon. Now, in a power off glide, the aircraft is going to obviously be descending, right? So the flight path angle is going to be below the local horizon. So this is the actual travel path of the aircraft. And if we look at it, it's going to have three of the four forces acting on it. It's not going to have any thrust because the engines are off. It's going to have a lift value, obviously perpendicular to this velocity. It's going to have a drag, which I'm going to put back here. Oh, my pen. Come on, pen. It's got a drag, which is acting parallel, but in the opposite direction to the velocity. And then it's going to have a weight, which is acting straight down. And of course, we know the height that we're at, and we're trying to figure out the range that it's going to travel. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take this weight value here, this weight vector, it's got a direction, and what we're going to do is we're going to split it up into a weight component that acts along the lift vector, and then we can also have a weight component along the drag vector, weight due to drag. Now since we're in an equilibrium state where we're not accelerating, the lift is going to have to equal this component of weight. And then the drag is going to also have to equal this component of weight. So if we write out those equations right here on the left, we'll get, lift is equal to the weight times the cosine of the flight angle. And then we'll also get drag is equal to the weight times the sine of the flight angle. Now, if you remember your trigonometry, tangent of an angle is the same as sine of an angle over cosine of an angle. If we flip these, we can have sine of the flight path angle over cosine of the flight path angle equals tangent of the flight path angle, and that is equal to the drag over lift, or 1 over the lift to drag. And we have that value. This will give us the flight path angle. And with knowing the flight path angle over here, that's the same as this flight path angle over here. We can use some trigonometry to figure out what this range is with this flight path angle and this height. That's what we're going to try and do. So rearranging this equation, the flight path angle is equal to tan inverse of 1 over lift to drag, which equals 10 inverse of 1 over 7.7. Now, if you plug this into your calculator, you're going to get a flight path angle of 7.4 degrees. Now, looking over here at the triangle that's made between the height, the range, and the flight path of the actual aircraft, and using trigonometry, we know that tangent of the flight path angle is equal to the height over the range. And so what we can do is we can solve that for the range, and range will equal the height divided by tangent of the flight path angle. And if you plug in the values we know, that will give you 7,500 feet over tangent of, 7.4 degrees. Plugging that into the calculator, you will get an answer of, plugging that into your calculator, you'll get a range of 57,750 feet. And that's your answer, so go ahead and box it. But we're not done yet. I want to show you another little trick. Now, if you look back up here when we were trying to find the flight path angle, we have tangent of the flight path angle equals the drag over the lift. Now, we can actually substitute that into this equation right here and get an equation that says the range, sorry about that, the range is equal to the height times the drag over the lift, or rewriting that, it's equal times the height times the lift over drag ratio. Now, if you plug in the values we know, which would be 7,500 feet times 7.7, plug that into your calculator, you will get an answer of, surprise, surprise, 57,750 feet. As you can see, we get the same answer between both methods. Now, if your problem statement asks what the flight path angle is, then I would suggest using this first method. If it doesn't care what your flight path angle is, like for the instance, this one only asked what the distance was. It doesn't say, you know, and what is the flight path angle? So in that case, I would recommend using this second one because you can avoid this intermediate step and just go straight to the answer.